In today's video, I'm going to be building on my last video by sharing with you another free SEO tool that you can use once or twice every single day to really dig deeply into the questions that people are asking in the niche that you're serving. By the end of this video, you'll be able to use this same tool to find a ton of great long tail phrases that you can start targeting for your own website. Digging right in, the tool today is brought to us by Outranking. Outranking is a tool that essentially helps us in researching, writing, and optimizing our content for higher organic traffic. So they have a suite of tools that essentially dig into things like what sort of things you should include in your content in order to have a higher chance of ranking, as well as how to optimize your content before you publish it so that you actually fulfill search intent for different phrases. So overall, you don't actually need to use Outranking in order to use the tool that I'm going to be showing for you today. However, I did find this by just literally searching for People Also Ask tool on Google, digging through some of the top results and seeing that this tool was super helpful. So what you're gonna wanna do is you're going to want to go to outranking.com site, and then you're gonna wanna go to the resources section and then go to the free questions tool in their navigation. From here, what you're going to be redirected to is this page, and this is really the money page of this video. The purpose of this page is you're going to input a particular phrase or topic that you want to get the output for of all of the questions that people also ask. So in my recent video, I went over the example of soccer, so I'm going to use that same example today just to show you just how comprehensive this particular tool is. When I go here, I'm just going to type in soccer. And then I'm gonna press search. And then from there, it's going to start to go through the results for me and look through literally every single question under the sun that people search for related to soccer. So you're only gonna get one or two of these searches for free every single day. You might be able to get an extra one by going into your incognito browser, but I find that this tool is so extensive that you're gonna find that you have so many results that you don't even need all that many more searches in a day in order to get some meaningful work out of this. So I'm gonna go ahead and fast forward this video to the search results right here.
A few moments later. Ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba. One eternity later.
Okay, I'm gonna pause the video here and I'm just gonna...
1 minute, 37 seconds later.
And boom, right there, it's going to output all of these results around soccer. So there are 56 search results around soccer, and you can see how you have a filter section at the very top here that is super, super helpful. So if I zoom in a little bit, just so it's easier for you to see, you can see that there's selection types like questions with search volume, relevant, what, why, when, how, where, which, can, and are phrases. You know that from my last video, I shared with you the importance of answering these sorts of 5 W's and how questions. I've emphasized this over and over again on my channel. So if you haven't watched my prior SEO videos, be sure to check those out on the importance of that. But the first thing I like to do is I like to organize and filter by the ones that have search volume. And that's because that'll output for me the things that are higher probability targets for me to go after when it comes to building organic traffic than just kind of shooting in the dark on a phrase that potentially doesn't have meaningful monthly traffic. So in this case, once I've done that, what you'll notice is that it will output for me the different long tail questions that people are asking around soccer. So you can see here, for example, that there's questions like how to draw a soccer ball and things like that. And if I were to actually go ahead and just right click this and then search Google for this phrase, I have keywords everywhere on, and you'll notice that the difference in the volume here, this says that it's 9,900 a month versus Outranking's estimate of 6,600. So there's always gonna be variance across different keyword tools. However, the competition is zero for this particular phrase. And you can see how from this, you could start to work your way down by combining this with keywords everywhere. On the right-hand side, you can see all these other phrases that would potentially be also helpful to go after from related phrases to the original question you started with. So in this particular example, I'm initially looking at how to draw a soccer ball, but right after that, I might create a cluster of content in which the next piece I would cover is how to draw a soccer player. I might include in my section on how to draw a soccer ball easy, because it seems like it's lower volume, however, potentially even lower competition relative to these phrases because it's more specific. And then I can also look at things like how to draw a soccer ball on fire and things like that. So I can either choose to create 3 different pieces of content around how to draw a soccer ball, or I can create one piece of awesome content and then have the on fire section and the easy section or the hard section be subheaders to that particular piece of content. So what's really helpful with this outranking.io free tool is that it pretty much pulls a ton of the questions that you would have to dig through by yourself and then gives you an initial screen for keyword volumes. So even in the case where you don't have a Keywords Everywhere subscription or whatever subscription you might be using to figure out estimated volume, you would at least get a rough estimate from this tool and then also be able to see all the other phrases around the particular topic that you're thinking about. And you can also do this in a much more precise way as well, in which I could potentially search for just soccer ball and see exactly what sort of things might be coming into there. So let's go ahead and take a look at specifically maybe something around why soccer, and then I'll input this search result and then I'll speed up and then we'll see some of the results of exactly what it's going to come out with. And boom, just like magic, what you'll see here is that the outranking tool has output 1,166 search results around the phrase why soccer. So the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna filter by the ones that are questions with search volume, and you're going to notice so many long tail phrases that these are all content ideas, right? These are all potentially good content ideas that we can chase after if we were building some sort of site around soccer. So what I would do from here is, depending on where my domain rank is, I would take my strategy and adapt it based off of that. If my domain rank is something below 20, then what I would do is I would probably look at a lot of the phrases below 100 in monthly volume, because those are probably gonna be much lower competition for me to rank for. However, in the case where my site had an even higher domain authority, then I might be able to just go after some of those phrases that already have hundreds of searches. But you'll notice as I work my way through this list that there are just so many different questions that are in this mix of things. You can see things like, why do Americans call football soccer? Or, why is a soccer field called a pitch? Why is soccer not popular in the US? And all these different content ideas that we could build off of. And then from there, after we cover all these why questions, we can start covering the how questions. And once we cover the how questions, we can cover the what questions and so on. So this is a great way for you to just create a long backlog of content for the sites that you're building, regardless of whatever niche you are building in. If you think this tool is gonna be super helpful for me, do me a favor and hit that like button below so you can help other people find this tool too. Overall though, from here, what I would do is I would just spend an afternoon looking through all these different phrases and then creating a backlog of content ideas to put into my content calendar. And then I would start to create content briefs for these pieces, start outsourcing them to writers, and then start creating content around these particular phrases. If you were to do this just for 20, 40, 60, or even 100 of these questions, I promise you that you will start generating meaningful organic traffic. And the reason why I say this is because I literally have taken this approach and applied it to 3 or 4 different niches in the past and seen remarkable results year over year from just applying this strategy. To try this out yourself, all you need to do is go to outranking.io, check out their free questions tool, and then start building out your content calendar. Now I want to hear from you guys. What are you going to be using this tool for? Tell me in the comments below. I love hearing from you guys, and I try to read and respond to every single comment. If you made it this far in this video, you are the real MVP. Thank you so much for watching all the way to this point. And if you want more content like this, consider subscribing for more digital marketing, sales, and entrepreneurship content every single week. In case you haven't downloaded it, I have a content marketing jumpstart kit that has tons of tips and tricks just like this that'll help you level up your digital marketing if you are just getting started. I'll catch you guys in the next video, but in the meantime, check out these videos that YouTube thinks you might like.